In this clip, we're going to briefly talk about heart rate variability. So, heart rate is the speed at which the heart beats, or more precisely, the number of heartbeats per unit of time, usually per minute. Now, you can easily count the beats for a minute by simply feeling the pulse on your wrist. Or if you want to do it in a more precise way, then you can measure the time between two heartbeats. So, in order to do this, we'd measure our ECG first and then the time between two R peaks. Now, why do we need this precise info? Well, because our heart rate changes every time we breathe in and out. Let me show you an example. So, as you can see, every time we breathe in, our heart rate increases, and every time we breathe out, it decreases. This is controlled by the body's autonomic nervous system, and in particular by the vagus nerve, which has a strong impact on our heart rate. In turn, the autonomic nervous system is closely linked to our emotional system, having a direct effect on our stress and anxiety levels. It has been shown that stress reduces heart rate variability. So, stressed people will not show this sine wave-like pattern. However, as I have already stated, you can use breathing, and more specifically, deep breathing, to de-stress. And a good indicator for this is the heart rate variability, which is plotted here. So, I'm going to show you an exercise now which will help you reduce your stress levels. If you have an HRV monitor, like the ATIS, then you can directly see if your HRV increases. This is a form of biofeedback. In order to make it look more relaxing, we have plotted the heart rate changes here as these concentric circles. So, let's begin with our exercise. Please sit up straight with your spine erect but not stiff. Let your shoulders drop. And try to release any tension from your arm and back muscles that you might be aware of. Keep your head above your spine with your neck loose and your chin leaning slightly towards your chest. So now we're going to do a few minutes of slow, deep breathing, pulling the air from below and drawing that way our breath deep into the lower lobes of our lungs, thereby causing the abdominal wall to expand. So, once you're ready, take an in-breath and let it fill your lungs on the count of four. Once you've inhaled all the air you feel comfortable with, then start exhaling again on the count of four. So, let me show you first. Inhale. And exhale. And again. Inhale. And exhale. And keep repeating this process until your in-breath and out-breath have a smooth flow and the length of each is equal. Now, once you're comfortable with this, you could also add two extra counts on the out-breath. So it would be inhale on four and exhale on six. Let's do this again together. So inhale. And exhale.